Hey, it's Gino here from realeverydayenglish.com. If this is your first time here and you're a person who is trying to improve their English level, then you might want to consider subscribing to the channel. And if you do subscribe, make sure you smash the little bell notification so that you never miss a weekly upload. Now, in today's lesson, we're going to be teaching you some vocabulary using the television, but not in the traditional method. So let's do this. So the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to narrate what I can see on the television whilst the television is in silent mode. So it looks like these guys are inside an airport of some kind, and you can see that this guy on the right hand side here, he has a uniform on, so he's obviously some kind of security guard or some other member of staff from the airport. He has a shaved head, so he doesn't have any hair. He has a bald head. And in the background, you can see there are some posters, and the posters are talking about luggage and baggage. So when you take your suitcases and bags on holiday, we call it luggage. And you can see this guy's opening this suitcase, and they must suspect that these people have got something that they shouldn't have inside the suitcases. So they're going to open up the suitcases and search to see if they find anything that shouldn't be in there. Okay, so here we have two guys shaking hands. That's what we call that, is to shake hands. This guy has a blue suit on and he has a tie on. And the guy on the right, I mean, he also has a beard, and his beard is dark at the top, but then very gray at the bottom. So he's got a gray beard at the bottom, and his mustache, this area here, is very dark. He's clean shaven, so he doesn't have a beard. That's what we call clean shaven. And it looks like they're having some kind of heated exchange. It doesn't look very pleasant. But both of these guys, we would describe them as older guys, because they're not very young. They're maybe, we would say, in the 50s or something like that. And then in the background, you can see they're in some kind of hotel lobby. And in the background, you've got this guy wearing a suit, and there's a bar. This is a bar, or some kind of reception area, it looks like. Maybe it's not a bar, maybe it's a reception area. Okay, in this scene, we have a swimming pool, and there's a group of people here. They're hugging each other, greeting each other, we would say. There's an inflatable crocodile here. So in this scene, they're in the street, and it's a street in Spain, this. It's set in Spain. And now this man is chasing after this man. So he's chasing him down the street, and you can see this guy is running away. He's obviously scared. So he's coming to this, is it a shop or is it a bear? Oh, it's a bear. And you can see the people here are line dancing because they've got cowboy hats on. And this kind of dancing is called line dancing. So he's coming to the bear to find safety. But the question is will the other guy find him? So he's looking around to see if he can see the other guy now. He's quite scared. And these are people line dancing in the bear. Oh, he's caught him. He's grabbed hold of him. And now they're having like a struggle. But the guy has caught him, and now he's pushing him into the bear. And this guy looks very scared. He looks like he's really scared. And the guy who works behind the bear, the bear man, he looks very concerned. But the guy in the blue shirt is the, we would call the aggressor, because he's the one who's initiating the violence. So in this scene, the kid, you can see, this lad here, he can't swim, but he jumps into the pool. So he jumps into the pool, but he can't swim. So now his parents need to rescue him. So they're diving into the pool. And now they're getting him out. And his mum's here, this is his mum, she has a towel. And now she's crouching down to help him up. And now they're getting him out of the pool. So they've saved him. But you can see that these guys jumped in fully clothed. So all his clothes are now wet. And his mum has now wrapped a towel around him. And she's reassuring him that he's okay, giving him a hug. And this lady is pointing a gun at the man. So she's pointing the gun at him. Look, she has a gun in her hand and she's pointing it at him. And I think now she's going to make him jump off the boat. So she's instructing him that he needs to get off the boat, but he doesn't want to. Now she's pushing him, she's pushed him off, She's pushed him into the water. And now she's looking over the side to see if she can see him. And there's the man, he's struggling in the water. He can swim, but he looks like he's struggling. Oh, she's throwing a rope. So she's throwing him a rope to help him up. And I think she's going to help him back onto the boat. So here we have two men walking into a building. And they're walking up to the reception. So this must be a hotel. And now they're having a conversation with the guy. Looks like he wants to show him something on his phone. So he's showing him a photograph of these people, obviously asking the man if he's seen them. And this guy's saying no. You can tell that because he's shaking his head from side to side. But now he's offering him money. So he's offered him some money. So he's bribed him. We describe that as a bribe. So he's bribing him to give him information about the people in the photo. And it looks like now he's giving him some information. So now these two guys obviously know where the people are that they're looking for. Here we have some kind of cooking show, and you can see that this lady here, she has a yellow shirt or a yellow blouse on, and she has long dark hair, but she has a bobble in her hair. She's tied her hair up with a bobble, and now she's stirring the food in the pan. These are bowls, so she just placed a bowl onto the worktop, and now she's continuing to stir the food, which is in the pan. She has, looks like, turquoise trousers with white diamond shapes on. I'm not sure if the trousers are a skirt. I'm not sure. And then the guy on this side has a grey shirt on, and he's in a kitchen too. But this is a split screen because she's in a different location to him. You can see here she has a green cutting board. So this is a green cutting board, and you can see there's a knife resting on top of it. And now it looks like she's going to pour some kind of juice. So she's just poured some kind of gravy or juice into the food. Okay, that's it for this week's video, or today's video, should I say. Narrating over the television is actually a lot harder than it looks. Let me know what you think about the video in the comments. I'm just trying this out, trying new ideas on how to teach you guys new vocabulary. If you liked it, then give it a thumbs up and let me know. If you didn't like it, then also let me know. I like that feedback to know what the people who follow this channel need and want to take their English to another level. Having said that, have a great weekend, and I'll see you people in the next video. Ciao.